Hey, wonderful souls. I hope you all are doing well. This is Nirmal Arcot, your companion on this incredible journey of self-discovery. Before we begin, a quick heads up. If you are prone to motion sickness, consider just listening to the audio while you go about your tasks. This video explores the turbulent waters of problems we all encounter. I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to those who turned into my previous episode on overcoming shame. Your support means the world to me. For those joining us for the first time, a warm welcome to you. Be sure to check out the episode 1. The link is in the description below. I'm sending my heartfelt prayers for the safe journey of those braving nature's storm. Snowstorms and hurricanes causing delays and financial strains. Let's find strength in these trials. Recall the timeless wisdom, this too shall pass. May your travels be a story of resilience, navigating through storms to bright shores. Now, imagine this podcast as our refreshing dive into the warm waters. Today, our journey takes us into the depths of problems and pain. Drawing inspiration from M. Scott Peck's insightful book, The Road Less Traveled. These words echo through our lives daily, but fear not, I'm not here to offer solutions. Instead, I invite you to simply sit back, relax, and dive with me into the waters of life. We are all fellow travelers here, each carrying our own unique baggage. Together, let's unpack, lighten the load, and embrace the freedom. So buckle up, wanderers. We are in for an adventure where we celebrate victories, learn from detours, and support each other in this quest for a more genuine and joyful existence. Let's see what profound insights our major source of life, water, has to offer us today. Thank you in advance for your time and attention. Now, without further ado, let's embark on this exploration together. This video explores the turbulent waters of problems we all encounter. Life is difficult. This is a great truth, one of the greatest truths. It is a great truth because once we truly see this truth, we transcend it. Once we truly know that life is difficult, once we truly understand and accept it, then life is no longer difficult. Life has always felt tough for me. Even now, I think it's hard. I still find myself complaining about how difficult life is. A few years ago, when I first came to the United States, I went through a tough time like every immigrant goes through, adjusting to a new culture, a completely different way of life, and stepping out of my comfort zone stressed me out a lot. I even regretted choosing to come here, wishing I hadn't. However, as I started to realize these challenges, I saw that I had faced difficulties back in my home country and still made it this far. Difficulties are just a part of life. Recognize them, deal with them, learn from them, and then move on to the next one. Life seems to keep throwing new challenges at us, giving us time to appreciate how far we have come. I have come from Far East, where the sun rises. We believe in the sun god known as Surya, riding a chariot with 7 horses representing the 7 colors of visible light and the 7 days of week. I come from a traditional Tamil family, raised in Hyderabad, a city in India. Like many others, I come from a working class family, struggling month by month. That's tough, isn't it? On top of that, we all have big dreams, including me. So, what can we do now? Just keep dreaming and dealing with life's challenges? Most do not fully see this truth that life is difficult. Instead, they moan more or less incessantly, noisily or subtly, about the enormity of their problems, their burdens and their difficulties, as if life were generally easy, as if life should be easy. They voice their belief, noisily or subtly, that their difficulties represent a unique kind of affliction that should not be and that has somehow been especially visited upon them, or else upon their families, their tribe, their class, their nation, their race, or even their species, and not upon others. I know about this moaning because I have done my share. In the windy city of Chicago, I faced a lot of challenges. Life seemed like a tough song, with difficulties in money, goals, social situations, and education. Money was always tight. Even though I worked hard at a taxi company as a parking guy and cleaning cars in the snow, I barely had enough for basic things. Going to college felt like a far-off dream because of my money problems. I often complained about the barriers stopping me from reaching my educational goals. My dreams felt hard to reach. I wanted a future where I could succeed, but setbacks made it tough. Complaining about these barriers became a common thing. Being around people was hard for me. The city felt overwhelming and social events were uncomfortable. I moaned about struggling to connect with others in a world that expected constant socializing. School was challenging too. Juggling work and study was tough, and I moaned about the load of assignments and doubts that came with it. One day, in the snowy parking lot of taxi company, I struck up a conversation with a Vietnam War veteran who's working as a taxi driver. He shared the emotional journey of his time in Vietnam, where following orders, they had to search and destroy villages. In the process, they unintentionally destroyed crops and the food stored by villagers. This left them with a lack of food, and they survived on just one large potato a day for the next 2 months. Despite the difficulties he was pushed into during those days, now as a taxi driver in Chicago, he faces challenges with a different perspective. He shared how he found joy in facing the hurdles of life, realizing that the challenges he faced as a taxi driver were nothing compared to the hardships of the past, the lack of food, the destruction of villages, and the emotional toll of war were replaced by a sense of happiness in overcoming the challenges of everyday life. What makes life difficult is that the process of confronting and solving problems is a painful one. Problems, depending upon their nature, evoke in us frustration or grief or sadness or loneliness or guilt or regret or anger or fear or anxiety or anguish or despair. These are uncomfortable feelings, often very uncomfortable, often as painful as any kind of physical pain, sometimes equaling the very worst kind of physical pain. Once upon a time, there was a chapter in my life that brought physical pain and emotional despair together. Karma, my amazing white German shepherd and partner in all sorts of adventures. We were inseparable. But one day, Karma had to leave and a heavy cloud of sadness settled over everything. I couldn't eat or function. It felt like a big piece of my life puzzle was missing. Just when I thought things couldn't get sadder, another problem showed up. 2 days after saying goodbye to Karma, my foot met a sharp broken beer bottle. Ouch, it hurts a lot. While I was using something called alcohol to make the pain go away, but it didn't help much other than shattered in front of me and causing me to cripple the next 6 weeks. Now I am less functional, It turned out that the hurt on the outside was nothing compared to the deep sadness inside. Losing Karma was like a storm of feelings, and the cut on my heel was just a tiny raindrop in the storm. And so, I learned that some hurt are on outside, but the biggest hurt hide in our hearts. The first of the Four Noble Truths, Buddha taught, was the life is suffering. We attempt to skirt around problems rather than meet them head on. We attempt to get out of them rather than suffer through them. This tendency to avoid problems and the emotional suffering inherent in them is the primary basis of all human mental illness. Since most of us have this tendency to a greater or lesser degree, most of us are mentally ill to a greater or lesser degree, lacking complete mental health. Some of us will go to a quite extraordinary length to avoid our problems and the suffering they cause, proceeding far afield from all that is clearly good and sensible in order to try to find an easy way out, building the most elaborate fantasies in which to live, sometimes to the total exclusion of reality. Take the next few moments to reflect on the problems and pain you have faced in your life. Embrace the journey this far you have come. Take care, and bye now.